Hari Om. Hi, everyone. My name is Zach. And today we'll be looking at the practice of Nadi Suddhi, one of our pranayama practices. Nadi Suddhi is the nerve purification breath. It's our alternate nostril breathing breath. And it uses, traditionally in integral yoga, we use this Vishnu mudra here. So in Vishnu mudra, you're taking the first two fingers, the forefinger and middle finger, and tucking them down to the base of the thumb and leaving the other fingers lifted. And you'll see I do this with mine. You can tuck the pinky finger to help lift the ring finger if that's a little difficult for you. So this is typically what we use in integral yoga. And we'll use the thumb to block off one nostril and the ring finger to block off the other. So let's go ahead and begin the practice, and I'll mention a few benefits and a few things to keep in mind as we practice. You want to begin by blocking the right nostril and exhaling through the left nostril. And then when you need, inhaling through the left nostril, switching the fingers so that you then exhale through the right nostril. Eventually, at your own pace, you'll inhale through the right nostril. And at the top of that breath, switch the fingers and exhale through the left nostril. Continue at your own pace that pattern of exhale, inhale, switch. Exhale, inhale, switch. You want this breath to be extremely calm, very relaxed, no strain. Over time, the exhale can become up to twice as long as the inhale. This is nothing to be forced. It will naturally unfold in its own time, but you can place a little extra attention on the exhale and make sure that you're fully exhaling all the way out at the end. Over time, the ratio of inhale to exhales can grow up to 10-20. So 10 inhale and then 20 exhale. You want it to attain that ratio at a comfortable rhythm. So it's not that we're trying to forcibly inhale for a count of 10 and exhale for a count of 20, and then that's it. We want to be able to maintain whatever ratio we're at for an extended period, as in 5, 10, 15 minutes. So very comfortable. If during this practice you ever notice that your arm starts to get tired or your shoulder gets tight, it can be helpful to place your other hand under that elbow and help distribute the weight a little bit. Another option besides the elbow is actually under the armpit. This helps to create a little space around the lungs and to release tension in the neck and shoulder. So you can explore those options. This practice, again, is called the nerve purification practice. It's a very nourishing and soothing practice for our nervous system. Our sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous systems are helped to be brought into balance through this practice. And similarly, the left and right hemispheres of our brain become harmonized. So very balancing, very calming. It's a practice that is particularly good, I would say, at helping to calm us when we're agitated. If you ever notice yourself getting angry or frustrated, if there's an edge to you, and maybe you just woke up that way that particular day. Some days are like that. If you feel that sharpness, doing a little bit of Nadi Suddhi, a few minutes even, you'll notice that that edge physically starts to leave your body. There's just a little more calm, a little more space. So continue breathing as you have been for another minute or two. Another tip that some people like and some people it doesn't work for them. You can incorporate the Ujjayi breath, which is a slight constriction at the base of the throat so that it sounds like waves of an ocean internally. Sometimes that can help prolong our inhales and exhales. So you can explore that, and if it's helpful, incorporate it. And if not, there's no need for it. Now, in integral yoga, once you reach a ratio of 10 inhale and 20 exhale, we do start to incorporate retention as an option. We take this very slowly, so if this is a comfortable ratio for several minutes for you, then at the top of your inhale, you can start to retain the breath for 4 or 5 seconds at first. Check that that's comfortable, and then exhale for 20. I won't get more into the retention today, but just start slowly if you're at that point. As you retain, you can tuck the chin and hold the breath, and then lift before you exhale. As the next exhale comes from the right nostril, allow the hand to relax now. That will be a full cycle by concluding with an exhale through the right nostril. No need to rush if you're on the other side right now. As we conclude this practice, take a moment to focus on how you feel now. Notice perhaps if there's any difference now as opposed to when we started. And the last thing I will reemphasize is that this whole practice should be very calm, very calm, like a sensation of getting into a hot tub. Very relaxing. So I hope this has been helpful. I hope it's inspiring for your pranayama practice. And we'll see you next time. Om Shanti.